power spiked with the last discharge and then went out again, and I could see the aurora dancing around Tower 6. At the same time, the headache intensified, and I think I began to hallucinate. Old and new memories are clashing and tumbling around me. We're on the cusp of a breakthrough. I can feel it.
How best, Graham?
Morning, Frank.
You look a little out of breath. What's up?
Bloody observatory gates have failed. I came to see if I could borrow a ladder.
Bloody hell, there's a 12-foot drop the other side of that wall.
I'm old, but I'm not useless, no. Can I borrow the ladder?
No one said you were useless. Reese?
Hi, Frank.
Fetch Graham the ladder, will you, lad? It's round the side of the barn.
Will do.
And you be careful. I don't want Stephen Appleton coming mithering round here because you've broken your neck.
Bloody England. You can't just stop the train, stop people travelling about the place. I don't like it, Frank. I don't like it at all.
Well, nobody likes it. No sense sweating cobs over it.
Folk all riled about it, giving me grief. I didn't stop the bloody trains, did I? And did they give me any warning? No, they bloody didn't. Yesterday, it's all like, keep them calm, Howard, minor disruptions. And today, it's all government edicts and not until further notice. And you'll manage. Half the village has vanished.
It's a couple of people. It's hardly half the village.
Oh, right now. You forget, I've seen things. I was in the Falklands. I tell you, I got out the old air raid siren to test it this morning.
Air raid siren? What on earth are you going to do with one of those?
I found it in the station storeroom. Took it home, stuck it under the bed. Thought it might be worth something one day. Oh, damn it!
It's all right. It's just a nosebleed. Here, here's my Yankee. It's clean.
Oh, thanks, Frank, thanks. I've been getting like a bloody drain all day.
The radio telescope in Tower 6 is burned out. The background radiation coming in from the Penrose region is off the scale. It's like mathematics is bending along with the light. Everything is bathed in a strange glow. My face is still numb from the burn.
How's your sister, Frank?
We've not spoken since the funeral.
Ah, I see. Well, listen, I did rather wonder if you might do me a bit of a favor and check in on her, see if she's all right.
Dr. Wade, if they drop the bomb, there'd be no left but cockroaches and Wendy Boyles.
It's a bit odd, really. There's an old chap, John Coles, regular visitor at Lakeside, went walkabout sometime last night. Now it appears Mrs. Boughton has done the same.
Enid? Well, that'd be clever. They amputated her leg last spring.
Yes, that's the thing. I've also got a surgery full of people with nosebleeds and headaches. The council are saying influenza, but I've been practicing for 35 years and I'm not convinced. I just wondered if you might pop by and see her.
Even if I did, do you really think she'd let me in?
Fine. Forget it. I'll see her. Leave it to me. Oh, and Frank, call the hospital and get them to collect all this stuff. It's been 8 months.
I hung up on Stephen. He doesn't understand. Even if he were here to experience it directly, I'm still not sure he would. There has to be a way of consolidating, of offering reciprocal amplification to this signal.
Frank! Frank, for God's sake, stop!
Keep back, you bastard. I know what you've done.
Where's Lizzie? Where is she? I've got to find her.
You stay away. Someone's got to warn them. Someone's got to stop it.
You can't stop it. You have to understand. You hate me, I get that. But if we don't do this, it's not just the valley, it's everything, Frank. It's all gone.
You're talking bollocks.
You can't stop it! Jesus!
You take one step closer, I'll bash your bloody skull in, I swear to God!
All right, I'm going. But if you see Lizzie, tell her to get out, there's still time. Please, Frank, for her, not me.
If you're that bloody caring, you can save her yourself.
Don't you get it? I have to stay. Someone has to be here to confirm that everyone is dead.
Got the telescope up and running again, but the pattern has burnt itself onto the lens. It's soaking up light and radiation, but not routing it anywhere, so I can only guess that it's using it as an energy source in its attempts to communicate. It needs more power. I wonder if I could boost the reception by using multiple towers.
You never mentioned anything about them sickening yesterday.
I checked them last night on the way back, and they were fine. I woke up this morning, and the whole lot had gone. Tell me, Charlie, have you heard any birds today?
Well, I've not really been paying any attention.
That sister of mine reckons they're dropping out the sky all around the Reekin. And Dr. Wade reckons there's sick folk all over the village.
Meg said not to bother trying to get deliveries out. Set the quarantine in the whole valley. I reckon it's best we just sit it out. It'll all come right, Frank.
This'll all come right?
Yeah, right. I am sorry about your cows, Frank. But when things settle down, they'll see you all right. There's got to be provision for this sort of thing.
You want to listen to the radio more? Things don't seem like they're settling down at all. I tell you, Charlie, something big is happening. Hi! I want a word with you.
Jesus, what the bloody hell were you doing?
What are you up to?
Get out of my way. This is important.
You've been with Lizzie. You mess with her, I'll knock your bloody block off, son.
I need to track the pattern. It's critical.
What are you talking about, Stephen? People are sick. Birds are dying. My cows are dead. Where's Kate?
Still up at the tower for all I know. I could recalibrate the radial coordinates on the primary oscillators. If that holds up...
Stephen, where's Kate? What's going on?
Just keep out of my way.
There you go.
Oh, thanks, Frank. That should get it out of the way. I don't know what happened. It just died on me.
Give it another go.
Oh, I only just put petrol in it as well. Robert's taken the other car into town. I wish he'd get back. He promised me that he'd be back this morning.
You think he's off on another bender?
Oh, I can't police him all the time, Frank. He's not a child.
What's going on, Lizzie?
Nothing.
You're seeing Stephen again, aren't you? You two can't keep pithering on like this. If Robert hasn't already worked it out, he soon will.
Oh, not if he carries on drinking the way he is. Shit. Pardon my French, but bloody shitting thing. Why won't it start?
Come on, I'll give you a lift.
Thank you.
There's data coming through faster than I can encode it. I've already lost two processors. They keep burning out.
Please, I love you. You need to get out of there. It's not safe.
I need you, Steven. I need you here. I can open the gate manually. I can let you in.
It's too dangerous. You don't understand what's happening.
No, you don't understand. We can solve this. We can find a way. I just need more power. I need to amplify the signal, and I can't do it on my own. You saw the opportunity. You ran the numbers, remember?
We're responsible for all this. You and me.
It's not just you and me anymore, though, is it?
Jesus, Kate, you're trying to talk to it, aren't you? Kate, you can't.
Steven, I have to.
It's completely dead. It won't start.
It's only a short walk to the camp. I think we should split up. You go and fetch Rachel. I'll go back to the village and find Evie.
I don't think we should split up.
I don't want to either, Charlie, but we've got to. I'll meet you back at my house later on, okay? We can talk properly then.
Why won't you tell me what happened?
No, actually, you should stay at the camp tonight. Come and find me in the morning. Bring Rachel back. She's going to need her mother.
Meg.
Just take care of her.
Meg!
What is it, Charlie?
Nothing. Just be careful, that's all.
I will, I promise. You as well. I'll see you later on.
Why on earth are you there? Why aren't you calling from home?
It's hard to explain. I'm having to move around to follow it. When it finds a suitable host, it begins to amplify. Sorry, I'm not making much sense.
They're talking about flu and a quarantine on the radio, but this... I know you're not that kind of doctor, but it all just sounds really weird.
We don't know exactly what it is yet, but it's got something to do with the other night.
Stephen, your face, the mark. Do you think you're infected?
It's not a disease, Lizzie. It's something else. There's something Kate said about patterns. I can't grasp it clearly yet.
Okay, come over. Have some lunch. We can talk properly. Have you spoken with Kate?
Well, she's locked herself in the observatory. She's buried in the data. But it's already out here in the world. I need to see how it adapts.
How what adapts? Stephen, try to explain.
Lizzie, listen. Be ready. I need to go. It's moving again. I'll call you later.
Thank you.
Do you think she'll like it?
It's in an awful state, Stephen. I don't think so.
It'll be an adventure. It'll mean putting down roots here, maybe a family.
Are you sure she wants children? What, to stay here? It's not her place, you know.
Don't start that again, please.
I mean, she's ambitious, love, and she's, well, older. She's not going to want to stay cooped up at home looking after the kids.
Is that how you felt about me?
Oh, stop it, Stephen. That's not what I meant, and you know it. I'm just saying you should make a choice. If it's a family you want, well, you know how much Lizzie wants a family.
Jesus, Mum, I didn't come here for marriage guidance. I just asked what you thought about a fucking house.
Stephen Appleton, language!
Sorry, it's just that you have to understand, Kate is the most brilliant, extraordinary, wonderful person I've ever known. She's like no one else. The way she looks at things, it's like she has whole worlds inside her head. I don't think you or anyone really understands that.
Physical changes are evident. Although the butterfly burn is now faded, I can clearly see the change in my pores up close. As I record these words, I can feel myself hearing them as if for the first time, as if I'm both speaker and listener simultaneously. I am a scientist. I can only deal with the evidence I have. And this points in one simple direction. It's not in the observatory.
Station. Just keep this band clear. If you're still alive, I'll try and check in every hour. Kate, I've convinced them to use the gas. I didn't know how else to stop it. I couldn't save them. Kate, it's in us, too. I've made arrangements for myself after the strike, after I finish the job. You need to think of that too. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry about it. things. You know the protocol. That doesn't matter now. It's figured out how to circumvent the telecommunications blackout. What? I didn't think it could. Kate understood. She saw how adaptable it was. How smart.
Jesus Christ, you're talking about it like it's alive.
You have to assume that everyone here is infected.
We can't know
we
that.
We are infected. It's killed all the birds, and now it's in us. It's trying to leave the valley any way it can. The quarantine is not enough. You've got to remove the carriers. You've got to cut off its energy source, its food.
I've already told you, Stephen, I'm not going
to
water an airstrike.
You have to. Now it knows we're onto it, it's going to keep on spreading as fast as it can.
The quarantine and blackout will hold it in check. They've cut all of the phones out of the valley, so it's only you communicating out now.
Aren't you listening? It's figured out ways around it. Radio waves, something. All of the lines are cut, but the phones are working anyway. You've done all the right things, but it's not enough. You've got to stop it before it adapts again.
Stephen, my family, my wife and kids.
You know perfectly well what you've got to do.
I can't do it. Don't ask me to do it. You're asking me to sign their death warrant, my own family.
Damn it, don't you think I'm aware of that? I'll still be here when you drop the fucking stuff. Don't you lecture me about sacrifice, you spineless little shit. If you're so full of ideas, you come here and try dealing with it. Tell them the time when we had a choice is over. Tell them to do it. You've got to do it now.
You look well.
I don't. But thank you. You too. How are you settling in?
Nothing changes around here. I mean, it's great to be back. It still feels like home, I suppose. In a funny kind of way.
It's been a long time, Stephen. Last time you saw me, I could still walk properly.
You look pretty good to me.
Stop it.
For what it's worth, I'm sorry about how things worked out.
Or didn't.
Or didn't, right.
Do you think you made a mistake leaving?
My mum tells me it's never too late to change things, to put things right.
Funny. It's just what she said to me the other day. I have been wondering what she meant by that.
That's embarrassing. Sorry.
Maybe I should go.
Why?
Stephen, we're both married. I don't think this is a good idea.
What isn't? We're just two old friends having a drink, that's all.
Pressure in my eyes again. I can't move my legs, can't feel my face. When I collapsed, the light was waiting for me there. Caught me, lowered me here. Now it's pooling around my feet, watching me. The printers are spewing out page after page of zeros. It's frightened, too. It'll be okay. You. It's alone. It's scared. Oh, it's traveled so far. It's okay. I can help you. We can be together now. 10 seconds to signal fusion. We can be together. 3 seconds.
Thank you.
say. You knew what you were getting into.
Really?
Well, I'm sorry we don't measure up to your exacting standards, Dr. Collins. Maybe you just need to give us ordinary humans a break.
What? Ordinary humans like Lizzie Graves? Did you really think that I wouldn't find out? Frank told me. Or did you forget there's one person in this shithole who actually talks to me?
Kate, it was just a dream.
Don't bother, Stephen!
Oh, for Christ's sake. Kate, slow down.
You were engaged to her, Stephen. You nearly married her.
Oh, come on, it was just a drink.
Then why the hell did you lie to me about it?
Because I knew you'd be mad and then it would end up in a row. You wanted to focus on the event tonight.
Oh, so you were actually doing me a favor. Wow, I guess I just forgot to say thank you. Do not treat me like I'm an idiot.
You're overreacting. I know you're stressed.
Just don't.
Kate, come on, this is crazy.
What are you done to your face?
It's nothing. You collecting feed? Looks like the supplies haven't been coming in.
Again?
Phones are all strange. I can't pinpoint the logic of transmission.
You what? What are you doing with that paint?
Means the EMC are actually moving at the proper speed. Listen, Frank. Have you heard anything on the radio about a flu outbreak?
Doesn't seem much like flu to me.
They're shutting down access to the valley to try and isolate it. No. Something about the phones. I can't put my finger on it quite yet.
What are you talking about? Hey, I'm still talking to you. Where are you going?
Is there anyone there? Can anyone hear me? Clive. Clive, it's Stephen Appleton. Are you there? Can you hear me? Over. Come on, Clive. Where are you? Damn it. Kate, it's Stephen. Come in, Tau 6. Kate, are you there? Kate? Anyone? Hello? Can anyone hear me? This is Dr. Stephen Appleton broadcasting from within the quarantine zone. Can anybody hear me? Oh, God, no. No. Fucking hell, no!
This is Catherine Collins, recording for posterity. It's all over. I don't know how long I've got. Whatever he did, whatever the planes were carrying, it's burning my lungs. Probably some kind of nerve agent. I suspect it's only exposure to the pattern that has kept me alive this long. I'm making my way to Tower 6. I'm going to fuse the signals from the optical array. I just hope I can make it.
A daft old bird walking all the way out here for it. You know Charlie would have dropped it off.
What, and have that stinking great lorry of his poisoning my birds? He shouldn't be driving it on these lanes. It's a hazard.
I think he was hoping he could have a word with you about Frank.
There's nothing to say.
Oh, listen, Wendy, they might all be scared of you, but that's not going to work with me. You're 68 years old. Grow up. Talk to Frank.
How dare you speak to me like that? Give me my bird feeder right now.
Promise me you'll drop by and see your brother.
Megan Holloway, give
me... Not a chance. Promise me. It's for your own good, and you know it.
You are a shamelessly manipulative and difficult woman. It's no wonder Charlie adores you so much.
No wonder I do what?
No wonder you never finish what you start. I thought I told you to check the incoming stock orders. Wendy, one bird feeder for you. I'll tell Frank you'll stop by.
Oh!
Charlie, stop mooning around and stick the kettle on. Make yourself useful.
Appleton!
What are you doing here?
You thieving bastard. I knew it was you.
Listen, take everything you need. But then you have to leave. You don't understand. You can't be near me.
Painting these stupid little pictures. Stealing food. You always were a little prick.
Please, every second we're in proximity makes it worse. I'm a primary conduit.
You're a fucking disgrace. Come here!
Don't touch me! Get off!
What's going on?
Come in here! Lord, get over us! Thinking you're so much better
Sam,
than the rest
please.
Of us.
No physical
you
contact.
You and your stupid fucking
Sam,
missus.
Stop
She's
it.
Better than any of you.
Sam. Sam.
Is he?
Meg, please.
Don't come near me.
Meg.
Charlie.
Meg, wait.
Don't touch me.
Meg, please, you have to understand. It was an accident.
Get off her.
Let go. Let's just go.
Charlie. You have to understand, it was an accident.
Just leave him. Leave him!
What have you done, Appleton, you bastard?
Come on, Charlie, let's
Beg
just get
Charlie,
out of here!
Please!
Thank you.
Station Master's house. Howard Lantham speaking.
Howard, it's Clive. Clive Smith. I need you to listen to me and not ask questions or interrupt. Can you do that?
Yeah, I can. But why are you calling?
The Emergency Measures Committee is imposing a quarantine around the valley. We've got an influenza outbreak in the village. We're suspending rail services, and we're also going to be shutting down the roads for a bit. You're going to be dealing with some anxious people, Howard, so you need to explain. It's all under control, and we'll be back to normal in a few days.
All right.
Open up the emergency store. There's posters and boards, along with a bunch of stuff that hasn't been used since the war. Grab anything you think might be useful. I need you to close up any unoccupied buildings, put posters up, that sort of thing. Make sure everything is all squared away and shipshape. You are a military man, I'm sure you understand that. Everyone doing their bit, following their orders. All right?
All right, I think.
Good man. I knew we could count on you.
Ah, Jesus, Blaze. What the hell was that?
Repeating over and over to myself in the dark, eating cold food from a can with my fingers. My name is Catherine Collins. I am Catherine Collins. As if I can force the world to acknowledge my existence. Time has ceased to exist in any real terms. I'm reduced to marking out the days on the walls, like a cavewoman.
Darling Stephen, I don't know if you'll ever listen to this. Maybe you've decided to stay with Cade, and I can't blame you for that. But I can't wait for you either. I've got to think about the baby. And, well, I should have left a long time ago. I've run out of excuses for not leaving now. But I do love you, Stephen. And I hope you find peace one way or another. Oh, there's planes coming.
They stare at me. Yesterday I went into the village and this old woman just stopped in the middle of the street and stared at me like I had two heads.
Oh, don't be so melodramatic.
I'm like a walking freak show. Oh, this place, it's so insular. I just don't understand how you grew up here.
Well, I was very different then. And they're not so bad, really.
That's easy for you to say.
Just give it a bloody chance, Kate. This was the deal. A year here, and we could be in with a real shot at Lucia.
Stephen!
Oh, Christ, it's Lantham.
Stephen Appleton, I thought it was you. What's all this about a young wife? Oh, hello.
Two heads, Stephen. Hi, I'm Kate.
It's all over the valley. Don't you get that? This isn't some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the tower has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here.
you won't help me, I'll do it on my own. I'm gonna route all the power back through Tower 6.
Kate!
Wait, wait. It's trying to break through again.
Wait!
Lizzie, Mrs. Graves!
Rachel?
Hey, what on earth's going on?
It's been awful. The thunder and the lightning, and all the power went out, and everyone was in the hall, so I told them all to stay put. But then Sean Davis said he wasn't going to be told what to do by a stupid bloody girl and went out for a cigarette, and then didn't come back. And then Di, she went out after him and she didn't come back either.
Where is Dylan? Was he with Sean and Di?
No, I'd be looking after him. Do you think they'll come back?
I don't know, Rachel.
I don't care what anyone thinks. I just know if he was my baby, I could never leave him. Even if the whole war was coming to an end, I'd make sure he came first.
You'd be a good mum, Rachel. Oh, don't worry. It's fine. Go back inside and tell everyone that they're doing a great job. A really wonderful job. I just got a few things to finish up here, and then I'll come in and join you.
Right.
Go on.